Hi, welcome to another Witch Doctors DIY Garage, where we show you how to do it yourself so you can save yourself some money. One thing we're going to show you today is a Vision Stereo upgrade. It's our amp kit and our front speaker kit for a Vision. Our system is plug and play completely. You'll see how easy it is if any of you guys have seen those stereos or the amp kits that we sell for the cross countries. Same sort of an idea. Everything's plug and play. You can hook it up real easy. Vision takes a little longer because you got so much stuff to take off, the cover and the front piece and the seat, and there's a lot of stuff to do. Not hard. We're not going to show you that in this video just because we have other videos to show you how to remove the center console, how to take the seat off, how to take the front fairing piece off up on the top. It's really easy, but we're not going to put that in this video because you can watch the other ones. But let's go over and we'll show you the system and how cool it is. Alright, so on our system, we have the amp, Rockford Fosgate amp, we have our wiring harnesses, and I'll show you a little more detail. We have our Alpine speakers, the front speakers, they go right in. The one thing with these is the magnet on the back is so big that it hits the box, so we'll show you. A lot of these guys are trying to heat their boxes up and everything and melt the box that this goes into, and that'll make more sense in a minute when I show you. But you don't really have to do that. The magnet gives you the good sound. We'll show you how to go around that. But these bolt right in. No adapter rings, no anything. Our harnesses all come labeled. Everything's heat shrinked. It's got the label that tells you battery negative, the battery positive. So it tells you exactly where this harness goes. On the other harnesses, they're labeled for you exactly. The ends are on them. You know, left speaker, the other one obviously is going to say right speaker. So everything plugs in, no cutting, no anything. This one tells you the speakers there. So what you would do is you would just look at your amp and you see the speaker label on the amp. You just plug that in. There you go. That's it. And then you would plug these. When we're doing it in the bike, you would take the right speaker and you just plug this on. That one would go, you know, they're different size. So you can't really screw it up. That one would go on there. That one would go on there. It's that easy. The input side of things is the same way. It says on the label, it says amp input. So you can't really screw that up. And then the same thing, left input, and the other one will be right input. You would take that on your amp, and you flip it around. This side was the speaker side. So you flip it around. You have the input side. You just take this, plug it right into there, you're done. This will hook into the bike, and that's all there is to hooking up our system. It's that easy. We give you in the kit, you get obviously the wiring harnesses, you get everything you need, you get some zip ties to run this along. The wiring harness like under the seat. The amp mounts in the saddlebag, okay? So we've tried to figure out how to get it up under the fairing. There's no real easy way. It's just way too hard for the average person to do. So we mount it in the back in the saddlebag. Takes up very little space. We'll show you that. This does come with a mount. I don't have it in the video right now, but this does come with a mount to put it in there. The mount actually spaces it off the saddlebag just a little bit to get the air to circulate around it. So that is included in here, but I don't have it in the video here right now. So let's go over to the bike and we'll show you how to start putting this thing in. So you can see everything's already off of here. The center console's loose because we're gonna need to move that up so we can run the wires through here. It is just easier. I know some of you guys may say, I don't wanna go through all that. It's just way easier to do it. It takes 2 minutes to take it off. So the first thing we're gonna do is take out the factory speakers. They just have four bolts here. Now this stereo speakers, this stuff's already been messed with on this bike from a previous owner. So if your bolts don't look exactly the same as this, you know, no big deal. It's the same idea. They'll look really close. They may not be exact, but they'll look really close. And again, taking all these plastics off isn't hard. You watch my videos, it's really easy. It's just a lot of stuff to do. You know, it'd probably take you an hour to get all that stuff off. Okay, so you take the bolts out. The speaker will just kind of pull out. Now you have your wires on the back, okay? Just pull them off, okay? That disconnects the speaker, no big deal. Now the one thing you're going to want to do is these wires hook onto our amp kit. So what you can do is push them through. That's a little bit difficult. It's depending on how big your hands are. You have to push that wire through and get it out of this box. Now, as a little tip, you don't have to do this. There's some little screw looking things here. They're little push pins. They're actually kind of a real pain in the ass to deal with, but they're like a little rivet thing. You gotta, if you have to loosen your box up, you can pull these rivets out. That's what's holding it on right now. It's loose, but those are what's holding it on, okay? I don't know if you can see in here where this is all kind of goofed up right there. That's where somebody at one point tried to heat that up and melt it because they tried putting bigger speakers in and they melted this. If you do that, it will kind of work, but it's just a real pain and a lot of people blow a hole through there. They melt it too much and it really distorts everything and it's just more trouble than it's worth in my opinion. So that's that one. We did the same thing on this side. Do the same thing, disconnect these off the back. This one's a little bit easier. Now they have, and it's, you really can't see this because it's down in there, but there's a grommet around that wiring. You have to kind of force the grommet through the hole. You can use your wrench, you can use a screwdriver. Just kind of force that grommet. Watch you don't pinch the wires off. And again, really hard to see, but down in here is where that is. It's kind of a feel thing. You just kind of have to push it through. Like I say, you can take this speaker box. They come out. They're a little bit of a pain to come out, but you don't have to. And if you're not going to be able to get these connectors through this hole together. You have to put one connector through and then put the other one. See, there's the grommet, okay? You have to put one connector through the hole and then put the other one through because the hole's not big enough. My hands are too big to really get in here. Okay, so there you go. There's your connectors. Now, you're going to need these connectors, okay? So we just do the same thing on the other side. That one's a little bit easier to see, and you have a little bit more room here to do this one. So just push that through. One connector at a time through the hole. And there you go, okay? Now, one thing you can notice, they're different sizes, big and small. That does matter, okay? That's positive and negative type thing, so that does matter. But that's all you gotta do. So you're gonna have those hanging out here. And now your speakers are out, all your wiring's pretty much ready to go. So we'll get the harness and we'll kind of show you how to start putting that on. So in the saddlebag here, the amp is gonna go up in this area, up in here. It's gonna kind of go up in here and sit up in here. Has this little ledge to sit on. Now you can put it wherever you want. I wouldn't put it up that close just because then you can't hook the wires in. I'd kind of mount it back in here, you know, so you have some room to work. The wires are long enough. You could probably even mount it down here if you wanted. I like it up here. It just keeps it out of the way of stuff. These saddlebags are so small to begin with, but this will still, you know, you have room down in here to keep your junk. So up in here, a little bit easier. You want to have it so the connector here is facing the front. That's the battery. Now, all you do on this, and I can show you real quick, just jiggle it and it pulls right out. But you have B plus and G. That's battery positive and green. Or I'm sorry, green. Battery positive and ground. So that is the orange wire goes in there and the black wire goes in the ground, just like we have it labeled. All you do on this is you have these real tiny little screws. You back the screw out, stick the wire in, and tighten the screw up. That's all you do. So you can do that, you know, with the amp not being in there. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take the seat off. Okay, like I said, we already have that off. Now, down in here, you wanna just drill a hole. This is a fiberglass panel right here. So you just wanna drill a hole, you know, half inch hole or something down in here. You can see there's one already there, so we're just gonna drill it a little bigger. That hole is not in your bike. Again, this bike was kinda messed with. But just drill that out. Okay. So what we'll do now is we'll take our battery harness that's gonna run to the front. We're just gonna stick it in there. Okay? Just put it in there. You don't have to hook it up, just put it in there. Now, it's gonna just kind of follow along here. Right along this factory wiring harness is where we're gonna just put it in. So it's gonna follow right along here. Just follow it up. Now, we don't zip tie it on now just in case you do something wrong. But there's kind of this factory kind of clip here. Just tuck it in there. Okay. You can get it under here. Now, one thing I should have done, and I'll just, actually, let me redo this a little bit. Pull this out first. I know you're saying, ah, geez, I just ran it. It's easier to take this and put it under here first. Okay, so take that first. Then you can do that. And then stick it through the saddlebag. Just because that the connectors and the fuse and everything are too big to do that. So all you're gonna do is if you look down in here, there's just a mess of wiring. But this big harness runs right along the frame. You're just gonna kind of follow that along. Okay, that way everything will be out of the way. It'll be out of the way of your steering and everything. Just take that harness, and I know it's really hard to see what I'm doing here, but just take that harness, run it along there. Say we'll zip tie it later. And we're gonna drop it down, right down by the battery, okay? So we'll come back, we'll start the video in a second, and we'll show you down by the battery how we hook that up. So the next two ones, just take your speaker and your amp input and pop them through. We're gonna kinda just do all the wiring here now. Okay, just pop those through. You're gonna do the same thing. Now these are easier. You can stick these under a little bit easier. Just be careful with some of your other wiring here. And when you're doing this, just take your time so you don't stuff something through and break a terminal or something. You know, if it catches and you're pulling, you could pull the terminal off. So we're just gonna pull that wire through. You can kind of hook it in there, help hold it out of the way. Same thing on this one. Okay, now, like I say, you don't want to zip tie them yet, because you're gonna need to pull these wires, you know, longer, shorter, whatever. So don't zip tie anything yet, just kinda do it. Now, these are gonna run the same thing. We're gonna just tuck them down, just kinda like we did the battery, down underneath there. And just kinda let them hang down towards the front. just make sure they're out of the way of the steering. And like I say, if you follow that big harness, that's the factory harness, so you'll be okay. So you can see, if you can kind of see down in here, that's all we did. Everything is just kind of tucked real nice. Right here is all your stereo wires, okay? That's your whole harness right here. So you just kind of tuck it down along there. You can put a couple zip ties down in through there, and you can secure that thing right out of the way. Everything is real easy. And again, you could see, you could do that without taking this out, but it's too hard. This is just so easy to take off to do that. So now your wiring harness is run. So now we'll kind of tuck up under the front and show you how to hook everything up. So now we're going to connect the wires that we ran up to this terminal block, okay? And again, the little screws in there, they're real small. I use a real tiny little screwdriver, okay? So again, the B plus goes to the positive, the orange wire. Now, one reason we don't zip tie is because we don't want to work down here and try to figure this out. Pull the wire through. Get it where you can work on it. Okay, so all you do is put this in that terminal there, B plus. Stuff it in there. Now make sure you get it in there good. And the other one, pull the thing back. The battery one goes in the bat or in the ground. Battery in the B. Must have said that 100 times, right? Make sure these twist these together a little bit so you don't have all the strands. Okay. Put that in there like that. And then tighten the screws. Now the reason you're doing this now, because if you had this hooked up to the battery, okay, and these wires touched, you'd get arcing and you could cause a fire. You don't want to do that. Hook this up first before you put it on the battery in the front, okay? So now that's on there secure. You don't have to plug it into the amp, but you can. We will now. Okay, again, do it out here where you have room. Just plug that right into there. Pull your wire here. You need a little more room. Pull it out. Speakers, input, no. Speakers, yes. Okay, so plug that into the speakers. Your other amp input goes into there, and you're basically done. That's all hooked up. So you can pull your wires kind of where you need them. Okay, we'll just set this here for now, but get the wires out. You may want to take a zip tie and tie them up right here, you know, to keep them out of the way so you don't get them caught on stuff when you put in your saddlebag, but you can do that later. Just kind of get that where it's going to go. Now you can start to kind of have, you know, your length back there, so you can start to kind of pull these wires up through. You don't need all that extra. So you can start to pull them through a little bit. Don't pull them all the way, you know, but it gets you a little bit closer to what you need, so you'll have some room to work in the front. Now, okay, so that's roughly what you're going to need. The one thing you can do is once you get where your amp is and you kind of figure out your exact length there, you can take a zip tie. It's probably a good idea. Just run a zip tie around here to at least hold them, because when you're pulling, you don't want to pull them out of whack. You know you need that much length there. So you can start to slowly work your way up. Just to hold them. Just another little thing for you guys. This right here, if you ever wondered, this is your shock right here. And right on this side is your lowering link. Okay, so the lowering links we sell to make the bike lower, that's where they go. Just a little tip there. That's what you're looking at right here. That's the little teeter-totter in the top for where the shock connects and the lowering link connect. So that's that right there. So now we'll go back down under the front. We'll try to show you where these wires go. So now we're going to take this speaker and amp wires that we ran along here. Now the one thing you're going to want to do, and we tried to get this so you could see a little better, we're going underneath the top of the triple tree, okay? We're not going between the handlebar and the triple tree. We're going underneath it, okay? So make sure you run those wires there. What we're going to do, and you can't see this in the camera, but right roughly in here, next to the speaker box, right in here, there's a big hole. You can see it from the front. So that's where I'm going to run these wires. I'm going to run the wires up through this hole right here. So he'll go around and show you in the front. And the hole I'm talking about is right here, okay? So if you can kind of see this, right through there. They come right through there with no problem. Okay. And again, just be careful when you're putting these through there that you don't knock the connectors off. Okay? So that's that easy. Comes right through there. Okay, just let them hang and then do your other one. Okay, so there you go. So now, this is your inputs, okay? And this is really pretty self-explanatory because it only goes one way. This is going to go to here, and the other end is going to go to the other side. And it'll tell you that, left input, that's going over there. So all you're going to do, and if you remember earlier, I said big and little, the connectors are big and little. It's only going to go one way, okay? Plug that into there. Plug that into there, you're good to go there. Do the same thing on the other side. Plug it in. Plug it in. Now, I have seen some of these terminals where people have done this a bunch of times, trying speakers, goofing stuff up, to where these actually are really loose in there. If yours are loose, just run some electrical tape around there so that these don't vibrate out, okay? These are pretty tight, so you're okay. But if that happens to you, make sure you put some tape around there to hold those together. Now, this is basically done. So you can just tuck it down, you know, wherever, out of the way. If you have a power windshield, make sure you're out of the way of the motor. The arms here, make sure all that's clear. Now, the other wiring harness that's left, this is going to go to your speakers. So you have right speaker, left speaker, obviously different length wires. You're going to do the exact same thing. And that hole that we had earlier, that we took the factory wire out, that's kind of down in there, that's where these have to go. Now, I can tell you, this is a little bit of a pain because it's hard to get down in there. Patience is what I tell you. I don't have a lot of patience, probably like most of you guys, but if you kind of work it and you reach inside the box, you can do it. If you can get one through, that'll really help because now you have something you can kind of pull and hold. Okay, so that's through. Now, if you notice, we give you a lot of extra wire. A lot of things, they give you barely enough wire and you have to try to hook this on the speaker down in here and it's really tight. We give you plenty of wire. So there you go. So now that's going to hook to your speaker. So you do the same thing on the other side. And you just got to kind of feel around. And if you look from the back side here, you can see the wire through that hole. So you know if you're getting close or if you got to go up or down or whatever. You can actually see them. Okay, so you can tuck that wire. I like to kind of tuck it up under here. So that's it. That's everything there is to it. Again, if you have a lot of extra slack here, you can pull it back towards the back of the bike and zip tie it in. But for the most part, you're done. That is your wiring harness. We have to hook it onto the battery, but that's really the last step. We'll do that, and then we'll come back and we'll pop these onto the speakers, and then you can try it out and see how everything sounds before you finish everything. That way, if for some reason you got the left on the right or whatever, you can still come back and change what you need to change. Or you look at it and you're like, oh, that wire's tangled around something. You can come back and fix it now before you put everything back together. But we want to test it out, make sure it turns on, make sure everything works before you bolt everything back together. So we'll come back and we'll show you the next step. Next thing we're going to do is hook it to the harness here to the battery. So you want to do the positive and the negative. Now when I fish this harness down through here, you can kind of follow the wires that are already here. Okay, there's a brake line and stuff right here. Up in here, if you can see this, there's a brake line. So you can just kind of run those wires down through here. There's a lot of sharp stuff under here. You want to be careful where you run this to not, you have to be careful to not hit the exhaust and not run it on a lot of that sharp stuff. So it's a little bit tricky. So we're going to tuck it down through here. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll zip tie this onto this brake line here and we'll bring the harness kind of around. And again, the orange goes to the positive. And don't tighten it up all the way because you want to swivel this around. Back up, fish it up, and again we'll pull it where we need it. And just kind of line your wires up here so they're out of the way of your wheel, all that stuff. Okay, tighten your battery connectors up. Now, we also have the fuse here. So our system is fused and we put it right here. So it's real easy for you to check or get to. You want to make sure, you put the cap back on, cover that back up when you're all done so that you can check it. But the cap just kind of, you know, folds on like that and snaps on. So now, before you forget, make sure you take that wire and zip tie it up. Because if you forget and you go to start the bike and that's resting on your exhaust, you're going to melt the harness. So just do it right now before you get sidetracked. Okay. If you have to use a couple zip ties, use a couple. Make sure you hold this away from that exhaust pipe and away from those sharp edges. And this brake line right here is a perfect place to put it. Okay, so that's good right now. Your battery harness is all hooked up. Put your cap back on the battery. So you're all good. Wires are out of the way. Everything's hooked up perfect. So we'll go up top and show you some more. So now we're going to just pull the wires, make sure everything's back. We're going to start getting all our tension out of everything. Or not our tension. We're going to start getting all the looseness out of everything. Now again, this is kind of hard to show you, but we're going to take that harness. I'm just going to zip tie it together. And you can zip tie it onto the other harness of the bike. Wrap the zip tie around both so it secures it to the factory harness. Okay. And just slowly work your way back. You know, make sure you got all your stuff. Don't pull it too tight. That's the one thing I want to tell you. Don't pull it too tight. But you can tuck that in there. You can tuck it in the middle here, whichever spot you want to use. Okay. Okay, so now your harness is pretty well tied. Everything's good, everything's out of the way. So now the next thing you're gonna do is check the power. So you're just gonna turn your key on and watch your amp, and it should turn on. You should have the blue light. Okay, so that means you got power. Everything's hooked up correctly. So far, so good. You can smile, you did it right. Now, one thing you can do is just hook a speaker on real quick. We have the stereo is on, the radio's on, okay? So these are actually, everything's working. So if you want to test it out, just take your speaker, and you can just pop this on. It's actually really the next step. So put those on. Be careful when you push these on. They go on really tight, and you can bend the factory, you can bend that tab, so be real careful. Okay, so you can put it on, just kind of set it there. Okay, so we have volume. So now you can really smile that everything's hooked up right. So your speakers work, okay? So we just shut the bike back off, no need to leave it on. And now you're gonna put your speakers in. So that one's ready to go there. Just put the other one on. Same thing, you really can't screw it up because they're by the size. Okay. Just kind of tuck that wire down in. Now this is where it can get tricky, because sometimes these things are a real pain to put back in. Victory uses a really goofy little rubber fitting thing that goes in that plastic box. And I usually, to be honest, have more trouble getting these things to line up. And you can't push, because if you push too hard, you will push that little rubber bushing right out and it'll drive you crazy. So this is definitely a finesse type thing. Just get them so that they're caught. And see, I thought that one was caught and it's not. This is, in my opinion, the worst, most frustrating part of this job. So we may just shut the camera off at times, because I have never, ever, ever had any luck on putting these in. It takes forever. Maybe you guys will walk right up and go, man, that was easy. But for me, it never works right. And the more frustrated you get, you start pushing, nothing lines up and it starts falling off. Now, you don't want to put these in really, really tight. If you remember, I said the magnet hits the back, okay? So you don't want to put them in tight, because you will pull those rubber bushings out of these things. And then you have to tear it all back apart to get those rubber bushings back in. So if you're having trouble, make sure you look at that bushing and see if it's still lined up or not. Wow, I'm actually having a little bit of luck here. And just snug those down a little bit. On some of them, you may have a little gap. You know, that's okay. It's not the end of the world. Because that, like I say, that magnet, if you tighten these screws up super tight, you're just gonna screw stuff up. Okay, so that's in there. These are not burned down really tight like you would tighten a normal bolt. They're just in there enough that they're holding the speaker. And that is, I mean, you can see I'm wobbling the bike. That thing is in there really good, okay? So just have a lot of finesse with that. So now we're just going to do the other one. And hopefully, this one will work just about as good. And the other thing, if you remember in the beginning, I said those little rivet clips that holds these boxes in. I don't like to take those out just for the reason they help hold this to all, so this all lines up right now. If you take those out, then you have to go and line stuff back up, and that gets to be even more of a pain. So this is actually working. I don't want to say that till I get this one done, but this is actually working pretty good. See, I said it. Now this one's not going in. Okay, it's just as they start to snug up, they just start getting a little tight. That's where you want to stop. All right, that one's still loose, but I'm not going to hold up the whole camera trying to get one screw in. You can see it's still strong. I'll come back and put that in later. But now, what you want to do is you want to just try the stereo out again, make sure everything comes on right. Okay. Now, we don't have any antenna hooked up, no iPod, nothing like that. I can get this back off. Okay, you can set this down so you can see your controllers. Okay. Okay. So everything works. So you know you're good to go. Now, the one thing that you'll notice is the speakers will sound much better once you get everything on, okay? So if you don't like the way they sound a million times better than factory. But if you don't like it, you really need to get all the covers put on, get all that stuff put on to see how they sound. But that's basically all there is to it. We would go back and we would stick the amp in there and mount it securely in there in the saddlebag. But that's all there is to it. All your wiring is tucked up out of the way. Make sure you turn your steering when you're doing this and make sure that your wires, like you didn't accidentally zip tie something onto the steering and now it's pulling the wires. Make sure you zip tie the stuff that goes to the frame. And that's all there is to it. So that's how to install the amp and speaker kit on a Vision. You guys can do that yourself and save some money. It's really easy. Check it out on witchdoctors.com. Thanks for watching. So on the 4-channel amp, everything is the same for the front, okay? The power, the speakers, everything is exactly the same. On the 4-channel amp, you just have an extra fitting. You have an extra input, and you have an extra speakers, okay? So what we give you on our rear harness is we give you another harness that has rear input and rear speakers. So you just run the wires through the same hole you ran all the other ones, okay? Fish those through, And the rear input goes right on where it says. If you look, this is speaker output and input. So the input goes in the one for the rear. It just plugs in. The other one goes into the speaker one. Just plug that in, okay? So you're all set. Now, if you look up through here, and I'll try to get the flashlight and show you here. You're gonna run the wires right through here, and it's fairly easy. If you run it right through that crack, you're gonna run them right through there and up through the back. And again, be careful. You don't want to screw up the terminals. But it's fairly easy to do that. And just pull that up through. And run the other one. There you go. You just pull it through and it tucks in under there real nice. Now these are going to go up into the speakers, so we'll show you how to take the speakers out. So inside the trunk you have the bolts here. These take the backrest off. So they're 6mm Allen. And this is doesn't get much simpler than this. Let's take these bolts out. Out and then the backrest will come out. It's got to kind of finagle it a little bit. Pull that out. Now back in here you have the little bolts here that hold the speaker grills on. Just take those out. Over here. Okay, and if you come around here, you should just lift these off. Now they're kind of snapped in the bottom a little bit. Just be careful. There you go. That they kind of clip in. So just be careful when you pull them out. But that gets you to your speakers. Now, you can do one other step, which you don't have to do. Makes life much easier. Take this panel right here off. There's a little bit smaller Allen. It's a 3mm Allen. Take this off and you can just get to the wiring so much easier. Now, when you pull this bolt out, there's a little washer on there that sticks. See that little washer on there? Make sure you don't lose that. Okay, now this panel kind of snaps in a little bit. Or I'm sorry, we've got two more screws up here. There we go. Now I just kind of unhook that and pull it out. Now you can see your wiring harness. You can tuck all that stuff up under here. It just makes it so much easier. Now the next thing we're going to do is pull the speakers out. Now that is a Torx head bolt. Now be careful, because underneath here there's little spacers. So when you're doing this, watch you don't lose those little spacers. You don't really need them for our speakers. See that little spacer fell out? But if you ever want to put back to stock, or you know, you save this stuff, be careful we don't lose them. So that speaker's out. You can see this isn't hard at all. You guys can do this. So just disconnect. Like I was telling you in the front on the video installing the front speakers, when I said we give you enough extra wire, this is why. This is a pain when you can't, they could have given you this much more wire and you could have done this so much easier. Just disconnect that. You won't use the speakers again. Same with this, disconnect this. Okay, so now you're gonna take on the harness, they're labeled left. Get that where you can see it. Left speaker and amp input. So that is just gonna run over here. Just kind of tie it in there right now. And the other one will say amp input and right speaker, okay? And just kind of loop that in here for now. So what you're gonna do is the ones that say the amp input, okay? You're just gonna hook that into the stock speaker wires. And the size is the same thing as the front. There's a big and a little one, okay? So you can't really goof it up. Plug that in there. Plug that in there. Again, if they're loose, throw some tape around them. And do the same thing over here. This one's gonna say left speaker and amp input. So amp input goes to the stock wires. You're almost done. Okay, so just tuck these wires. You can zip tie them down in. You don't really have to. You can put a zip tie down in there if you want. But that is the wiring thing. Now we'll come and show you how to do the speakers. So we're just gonna take the speaker now, and we're just gonna plug it on. It only goes one way, so you can't really screw that up. Be careful when you push those on. Okay, right now we're just going to set that one there. Set that one there. We're going to turn the bike on and just make sure they work. A second here to power up.
Fuel efficient. Come see us. We're Donnell Ford. We're on Market Street in Boardman, or DonnellFord.com.
Hey kids, do you love the Disney Channel? How about shows like Girl Meets
Then you want to just kind of check your stuff, make sure your fader works. All the other stuff's going to work fine. We'll try the fader here. If you can tell, that's going all the way to the front.
I'm Peyton List. I play
going all the way to the rear. So the fader works, no problem.
5 to 18 will be auditioning for TV commercials, TV shows, and even movies. We've helped kids get work on TV shows.
Okay, so now that we make sure that's good, everything's hooked up, we're just going to screw the speakers back in. Now I like to turn this so the wires are over here. Has a little bit more room to do it that way. Okay. Now, I think earlier I said you didn't need the spacers. You do need the spacers. I'm sorry. Just put the spacer on the screw, and then it'll slip over this. It's just a little bit easier. It's kind of hard for you to see that, I know, but that way you don't lose the spacer and drop it. And if you're wondering why you need that spacer, it's because this box has a lip on it. And the speaker doesn't really sit flush. Put that spacer in there. Okay, don't tighten the screws, you know, don't break them off. You don't need to make it that tight. And the same thing, make that so the wires are kind of over here. And they're not in the way. This is just kind of a finagling type thing there to do that. This one, the spacer, I'm trying to show you. Spacer, you can kind of actually drop it in there and it won't fall. You can kind of see it there. Okay, just tighten them up. And the last thing I like to do, and it sounds crazy, but I want to test it again. Just because when you put those in there, you could have bumped a wire. You want to figure that out now before you put everything back on and then figure out if you bumped a wire. So both speakers are working.
Believe in the unbelievable. Only at the greatest show on earth where legends live. Treat your family to an unrivaled and unforgettable event of legendary proportions. Kids tickets are $12. Restrictions and additional charges may apply.
Okay, so everything works perfect. So now we're just going to start putting everything back on kind of in the reverse order that we took it off. So if you remember, this went in. And you watch, this little foot right here goes in there. You gotta kind of snap that in there. So just be careful, because that, you can very easily poke it right through the speaker. If you're trying to force it, and you can do it. There's also a peg down here that goes in a little hole. So it's a little bit tricky. Just kind of get it in there. And don't tighten all the screws up first. If you watch any of my videos at all, you'll see where I say don't tighten stuff up. You want to get all the bolts in first before you tighten stuff up. Because it never fails. Something just doesn't quite line up and you need to scooch it around a little bit. So just get them in there. Leak a little bit off. And you can kind of see through here. If you look through there, you can kind of see where you're putting the bolt, so it helps. It's just plastic and this stuff doesn't really fit all that great. And you can see that was why we don't tighten the bolts up, because you can see how much we had to move that around. This one's quite a bit. more pain in the butt than I figured it would be. Okay, those are in. Now you can tighten these up. Okay, so that's pretty much that. You're gonna wanna put your speaker covers back in, and remember that kind of just slides underneath there. Put that, pop it on. Put that on, then open up your trunk. And now you'll come in the back. Grills in. Same deal, don't put them on until you get both screws in. So hopefully watching this, you'll see with this system, it's not that hard to do. The whole deal is gonna take you a couple hours, but you can see the stereo part takes not very long at all. It's all this plastic on these things and how you have to take all these covers off. But again, not hard. You know, I got confidence in you guys can do this. Okay. Now your backrest. Now the one thing you'll notice, it has these ears right here. This ear snaps down in there. So it's a little bit tricky, but you kind of get one of them in and then just pop this in, but make sure you get those in. Okay, and then the last thing is just going to be to bolt this up, and again you have to scooch it around a little bit. And there you have it. You have now just installed a Vision Stereo. Turn it on one last time. Make sure everything powers up again. Maybe there'll be a song playing this time and we can let you hear the music a little bit. Fader, everything works. Bass and treble, everything still works. Fader. Oh, hit the wrong button. Let's get a different station.
Reasonable down payment. We've helped literally thousands of.
Is there any stations that don't have commercials? Bass, treble, fader. I'll turn it up and see if you can tell that it's going front to back. Can you tell I haven't had much sleep? Fader. There we go. Now let's get the volume going.
Get away.
right, you've just installed your four-channel system or two-channel system in a Victory Vision with the Witch Doctors Plug and Play Kit. Thanks for watching. Go out and do this. You guys can do this. Get some cool tunes and go ride. Be safe.